Hey everyone, this is Prince Watercress, and welcome back to Let's Play Bubsy 2 for Super Nintendo, also for Sega Genesis. We are nearly finished with the first floor of the West Wing, after completing the flying and music stages, and now it's time to do the space pirate thing again.
Another swine mech.
Star Wreck. There's a familiar level name. And we are as far up and left as we can go here. See if this guy... Yes, we will. Okay. Could go for those marbles right now, but it's a good thing I didn't. Because we got to see all these things. And there's that one-up, which I kind of sort of forgot was there, but thankfully I grabbed it anyway. And it's a good thing I managed to use the gravity in my own favor because, well, one, I was able to get past all those spikes. And two, I was able to get all the way over here. I want to go over there, but I want to go back. That's my first death in a while. Instead, now that I'm back here, I'm gonna do some more exploring. Because why not? Right? And, I thought I was gonna land right on the edge that time, but apparently that was not the case. Oh, come on, I was trying to jump there. The delay in that jump kinda cost me. And I thought I was gonna move it right, but apparently that guy's just gonna stand still. Let's grab that smart bomb too while we're over there. Oh, this is wonderful. No, and I'm just gonna take care of him the old-fashioned way. And there we go. There's definitely gonna be a Band-Aid somewhere. It's a good thing I saved that. Oh, there was one right there. Well, isn't this something? Might as well go ahead and keep this guy in the shot there. Thing's telling me to go left as an alternate path, but I'm gonna keep exploring some more, see what happens. There we go. Got quite a few goats that I can hit with the ballzooka. So I'm definitely going to try to do that now. And I thought maybe I could hit like one of the projectiles there with the ballzooka, but well, that's not happening. And I'm gonna get like a ton of points doing this. Well, I was until I hit the ground. At least I can hit him with the ballzooka. No enemies over there. Huh. And it's still telling me to go to the left here. I'm gonna keep going to the right and shooting things with the ballzooka because I can. And it's a good thing I did, too, because... things. And that's about as many things as I could get. Thankfully, I'm not anywhere I haven't been yet. As far as I'm concerned, that would have made for a good... animated GIF. Right there, all that gliding I just did a couple of seconds ago. What does this take me to? Oh, this takes me over here below the... all those hooks. And now I'm back on the top path again. That is going to tell me to go... to... the left there, though. And I want to see if I can do this without getting caught by one of the hooks there. I don't think I've hit a checkpoint. Oh, I did hit a checkpoint. You know what? I'll go in here and see what happens. There's got to be some stuff I can pick up at the top or bottom if I can get to them in time. Don't think I'm going to find anything, though. Could surprise myself in the end, though. Whether the band is just way too close to the ground there. And we're over here now. Pretty much at the far end of the level. Might as well go ahead and destroy him. Am I anywhere that I've already been? No, I have not. This is indeed new material. Thought maybe I went someplace I already had, but thankfully, this is all new area to cover. And it's a good thing that I hit that switch because that'll allow me to get the power-ups down there if I can find a way down. And it looks like I just might. Whew, boy. I should have known that there would be spikes popping in and out here. Let's go ahead and grab everything. And then try not to die on the way back. Thankfully, there isn't a lot of floor to cover in case I do this horribly. Or anything here horribly. It's a good thing I glided right there because that allows me to find some new area to cover here. How was I supposed to see him coming? Also, I forgot it did the thing again, so I couldn't shoot the guy with the bazooka like I wanted. Oh, well. And more goat blasting action. If I can blast a goat. And let's see here. What happens if I go in this direction? What will happen? Not much. Besides that, of course. So not a lot of enemies here, as far as I can tell. Do want to take care of this guy the old-fashioned way and land right here so I don't really get myself in a whole heap of trouble. And we got these barriers again. And I should have known there was going to be an enemy or a sheep or something there. There's got to be a switch that I can trigger. And I don't think it's going to be in that direction. So I will go in that direction later on. There it is. Looks like I'm going to have to go to the right again just to ensure that I've found everything. Whoa, why did I put myself in that position? Nearly died yet again. Though, there is some new ground to cover here. And it's a good thing I found that switch too, otherwise I would have been having myself a rather hard time. Definitely going to shoot the suit here. And it doesn't look like there's much else. Yep, this is where we landed on that pig that one time. So let's go ahead and just go to the left from this point. Why not? Try not to die in the process. Alright, here we go. And it's a good thing I turned this off as well, this little barrier here, too. Otherwise, I wouldn't have been able to continue on. Something's gonna hit me on the way here, or the way to someplace, I just know it. Might as well destroy the projectile, too, while I take care of that guy. Got ourselves quite a bit of flying enemies. Stuff like that. I may have to drop down a little bit. Or maybe not. What happens if I go over here? Hey! That did take me to the end. Now, can I find a Band-Aid here? Well, I found one, but it's too late to grab it now. But I'm close to the end, though. That's a good thing. All I have to worry about now is just making my way to the end here. Is there another... Whoa! Almost ran right into some hooks there. Now I can run to my heart's content. Try to grab a whole bunch of marbles here, as many of those as I can. And it doesn't look like I'm going to be able to grab any more. But I feel like we've got quite a few more cards since we started going through here. 81. I'll go ahead and keep my 33 lives and my 81 cards. Why not? And now it's time to head to another Egyptian stage.
I am not.
King of De-Nile. And I believe this was also in the in-game demo as well. Do want to grab that diving suit. And that smart bomb. Feel like West Wing is probably the wing they expect you to start playing first, and then you play the East Wing later. That's what I'm inclined to believe. They start you off very simply here. What happens if I go in here? Minigame? Minigame. Manifold Destiny. Huh. I want to go to the right first. And I don't know why I'm going in that direction. Though there is a... No! I wanted that one-up! Tried to press right a couple times and I couldn't do it. But at least I got through here and I got quite a ton of points. I still wanted that one-up, though. Oh well.
I am not.
And now we got these kind of blocks that just keep disappearing in and out here. And that's going to lead to a water slide, and I don't know if I want to do that yet. So I'm just going to keep going to the right. There's a switch there. I don't know if that's going to lead me to virtually anything. I do want to... No, I can't do that. I'm going to go in here first. Ah. I want to go to the right here because that leads to some hidden stuff. And probably another opening. Not sure if I wanted to go in that direction, but I do go into a mini game just by going back. So it's always a good thing to check. And I'm going to go ahead and hit up the lower level here right away. Then I'm gonna turn the power up on this a little bit. Thankfully, this one is probably the easiest of all the mini-games, this little setup here. I don't think I'm going to hit that. No, I will not. Wasting some valuable time there. And let's crank the power up. I don't think I'm going to hit that dead center. Wow, wasted even more valuable time. Which means I'm not going to hit everything before the timer runs out. And I don't think I'm gonna hit that boat in time. Darn it, I definitely wanted a third extra life. Just so I can say that I did. Now to see if that door is a one-way door. Because I want to know if it is a one-way door, and it looks like it is. Well, I'm gonna go do some more exploring. And also do a diving suit level, because why not? I might as well. Drown and out. There is not a lot going on with the... No. You are not getting near me today. Be gone. Also, I kind of like the setup for this one. For this particular mini stage here. Do want to grab everything on the way to wherever it is that I want to go. See where the tornado was going before I went to the left there and got everything else. And watch that point total just go up. Wow.
Nothing can stop me now.
All right. Time to go further down. And it's a good thing I did, too, because there's a portable hole there. I don't know if I'll have another one-way door thing going on here. So I'm going to go in reverse here and see what happens. And make sure I have the bazooka equipped as I do so. Let's see what happens if I go in here. Oh. Well, that's good to know. Now, what happens if I go down here? Nothing. What happens if I take the... Ooh, it's a good thing I managed to get enough momentum to go all the way here, because now I have 99 ammo for the bazooka. Excellent. And there's nothing, gonna be nothing there. And that just takes me back to where I was. So, I got some really good, wait. Yeah, I am gonna have to hit that, because that'll get rid of the wall next to the switch. And then it'll open it up a path to the right. Okay. Why not? I will do some more exploring as I do this, though. And that exploration pays off with another switch. Another hidden passage that I can take advantage of. Which leads to a minigame. Tadpole vaulting. Again, you never see the goat with the yellow pants anywhere in the game. Find that kind of interesting. Now let's see if I can do this without wasting a ton of time. I probably can. I just gotta adjust the power on the little catapult there, and it's a good thing that I'm doing it, because this will allow me to hit some things dead center here. And can I hit these things dead center? Yes, I can, and with 11 seconds left on the clock! So I got another one of these things completely beat. Doing real good with the minigames here. Playing real good. And you know what? I'd rather just do some more exploration rather than go back in there. Hit that switch. And then, see where this area takes me. I just need to find it first. There it is. Huh. Why did I even bother? It's a one-way door. So now let's go down here, hit the marker, and we should be good as far as exploration is concerned. And there were those cars that I saw earlier. Don't know why I grabbed that. I wouldn't exactly say it was worth it. But I do need to be doing okay as far as exploration is concerned. What if I were to continue to keep looking down? Okay. And even more stuff. Good thing I went to the left then. And not heeded the arrow. And even more bazooka ammo. And we're starting to hit bottomless pits too. I've already done one of those. And I don't know why you would want to put marbles in on top of a bottomless pit. It just doesn't make any sense to me. Funny. I thought I had that equipped. I was wrong. Oh. So you can hit the switch and then go get them. Okay. Well. Whoa. Let's avoid the water here as we try to get the bandage here. And now that we have that switch triggered, we can go over here, trigger another marker, which will allow us to start here in case we accidentally die. And that just takes us back to whatever. We're as far right as we can go. Why another one? We just hit a marker. I guess they expect you to get all in the conundrum and just get lost in these levels. That's my logic. That's why you see one marker and then you see another one just 5 seconds later. And it's a good thing I tried to grab that. Really easy to miss continue there. Not that I'm personally going to need them because, well, it's pretty easy to gain lives when you know what you're doing. And we are now done with the first floor. All that we have left to do is to go to the boss room, fight off the enemies, and then we'll be on the second floor of the West Wing. I know that I can probably skip through all that and just get all the score tabulated instantly by pressing the start button, but why not?
Another swine mech.
Start the next floor off at another even 100 cards there. And now it is time.
Do you believe in miracles?
To do another random boss battle. And I thought I could land it right into that guy. Wow, I'm doing horribly. Wow, I am doing very horribly.
Bye-bye.
Trying to leap into everything.
Do you believe in miracles?
When I'm trying to land on them.
Do you believe in miracles?
Why did that hit me? Thank you. And all that's left is the spaceman, which has yet to show up. That was really good. There we go. Had to concentrate a little there, but managed to pull it off.
Another swine mech.
Also, you have just enough time to get through those boss gauntlets. Those little enemy gauntlets there. And, well, it just looks the same as the second floor on the other wing, except the floor's purple. And we will be going through that second floor in the next video. So join me next time where I take on the medieval level, and hopefully if my exploration of medieval level doesn't take one whole video, maybe something else, I'm not sure. But until then, this is PrinceWatercress. Take care, stay safe, and thanks for watching!